Senator Obama has declined to put forth a plan of his own. In a time of crisis when leadership is needed, Senator Obama has simply not provided it. And the truth is that we don't have time to wait for Senator Obama's input for our nation to act.
We are back on Race for the White House. That was Senator McCain taking a swipe at Senator Obama's economic plan while at a town hall in Scranton, Pennsylvania today. Joining me now from Chicago is Obama's senior economic advisor, Austin Goolsbee. Austin, welcome to the program.
Thank you.
How about that particular point? What is Senator Obama's vision for managing this crisis, and why not really take concrete steps to influence what the administration does?
David, that was crazy. He absolutely has taken concrete steps and has been taking them for a long time. Unlike John McCain. So for the last year has been outlining how we needed to reestablish public trust in our capital markets and outlined a specific 6-point plan to reestablish public oversight in the rules of the road just this week. Now, John McCain apparently forgot about that when he was writing his own plan. And the plan he wrote that he's saying is his plan could literally fit on a gas station receipt. I mean, it was 10 sentences long. It was nothing.
Let's talk about the vision, the way forward here. There's a big debate that's going to unfold on Capitol Hill about how to proceed. Is Senator Obama 100% happy with this bailout plan as the administration's laid it out?
No, certainly not. And you've seen him specifying his concerns. Now, he starts from a position of it's obvious we're in an extremely precarious situation. We've got the retirement savings of millions of Americans at risk because of this irresponsible, no rules of the road, Bush kind of McCain philosophy. But that said, once you're in the crisis and your house is on fire, you got to put the fire out. So he's not trying to play politics. What he is insisting on is that we have several basic things that must be included. A, we can't give a blank check to this administration. Given their track record, that would just be irresponsible. There has to be some oversight of something with a price tag of $700 billion. They can't just buy whatever they want at whatever prices they want. Two, there has to be concern about the core economic issues that got us into this crisis and they continue to face us. That means the state of the economy. We need more stimulus. It means dealing with the home ownership and the foreclosure crisis directly. It means looking at the behavior of the financial institutions who are going to be getting this rescue so that they don't just take the money and run and play business the same way they always have.
All right, let's talk about priorities here. David Broder, writing in the Washington Post, said this about how this financial crisis impacts the next administration, whoever is elected. To the quote board here, the next president, whoever he is, will face a budget shortfall, inherit a budget that is at least $500 billion out of balance, a record sum that will limit his ability to do any of the wonderful things being promised daily in the upbeat rhetoric of the campaign. The last thing candidates want to do is admit that if they win, they will be unable to deliver the goodies they have promised the voters. So here's the question then. How is this financial crisis that has hit Wall Street, hit the country, changed Senator Obama's priorities for his initial time in office?
Well, look, the first priority is if the marketplace and the economy facing the financial institutions or regular Americans looks like it does this week, then we have a new priority. We have to deal with that right out of the gate. So there's no question about that. But on the core issue, which is so it sounds like it's sort of behind your question of would Senator Obama abandon the things that he's talking about to foster the strength of the middle class because we have to deal with this? Let us not forget how we got into this problem. It is exactly the struggle of ordinary Americans unable to make their mortgage payments that got us into this situation. So if you truly we're going to abandon all of the paid for, I might add, programs that Obama is talking about and the direct tax relief for ordinary Americans, you would be setting yourself up for another one of these huge bailouts. So I really don't think that's the way to go.
Well, here's an exchange between CNBC's John Harwood and Senator Obama on the issue of taxes and spending. Let's watch.
Well, on the spending side, I think it's going to be important for us to deal with the health care crisis.
And, so no change in your health care plan?
But keep in mind, my health care plan is paid for. I continue to believe that rolling back the Bush tax cuts on the wealthiest Americans makes sense. They are still going to be wealthy after those are rolled back. I still believe that it is important for us to make college more affordable. And I think it's important that all those things are paid for in light of this huge additional potential expense.
Austin, he's moving forward on some of these plans, and he still wants to move forward, as you alluded to just a second ago, with tax cuts in addition to raising taxes by reversing the Bush tax cuts. How do you afford that at a time when the country is facing a budget deficit of what could approach $500 billion, let alone what the real cost of this bailout is going to be?
Senator Obama said it exactly right. As he has progressed through the last year and a half of this campaign, he has come up with pay-fors for every single thing that he has discussed. His program would reduce the deficit if enacted whole hog. If you took everything he had, he would shrink it. You should be asking this question of the McCain campaign, because they are talking about tax cuts for the biggest corporations and the highest income people and the most well-off CEOs that would literally add $350 billion a year to the deficit. Obama's program is paid for.
Let me ask you in general terms, this is the first time since 1932 that we have a presidential election in the middle of a financial crisis.
Yes.
What is it about Senator Obama, personal characteristics, that you can say to voters makes him the right guy to lead us out of this?
Well, I would say three things. First, he's been very thoughtful and very foresighted on this issue, has been talking in specific terms about how we needed to reestablish oversight of our financial markets for more than a year, in great contrast to John McCain, who's been trying to deregulate our financial markets for the last 26 years. Second, he's surrounded by a lot of extremely informed people, Paul Volcker, Warren Buffett, Bob Rubin, Larry Summers, Laura Tyson, the list of advisors that he has, including Republicans like Bill Donaldson. He's talked with Paul O'Neill. A bipartisan approach at a time of crisis is exactly what we need, not playing politics. And the third, he's been extremely vocal on what goes wrong if you start tearing up the rules of the road, as John McCain and George Bush and Phil Graham have tried to do. It's one of these things where John McCain has now discovered that he's complaining about recklessness of CEOs and financial institutions and reckless driving. But this is what happens when you tear down the road signs, when you slash the tires of the police cars, and you legalize carjacking. That's where we are.
I understand that, but this is the rhetoric of a campaign. I'm asking you both what makes him tick, but also who's going to be the strongest voice in his ear on the economy when he's going to have unsettled ground underneath him in this climate.
Well, I think you can look at the course of this campaign as a good indicator. He's the most important voice on the economy. He has gotten input from all sides. We've talked regularly with Bob Reich, with Jared Bernstein, with people from Wall Street, with people from industry, across the board, and that is the way he ticks. That's not invented for this campaign. That is the way he has always been.
Finally, might he keep Secretary Paulson on?
I don't know. That's way above my pay grade. I don't know anything.
But you advise him. Do you think that'd be a good idea?
Yeah, look, as I say, it's what we need to do now is address the concerns that are facing the economy in a moment of crisis.
Has Paulson done a good job in your judgment?
Look, as I say, Paulson, Bernanke, the leaders in Congress, Senator Obama, we're all trying to make sure this thing doesn't morph into a Great Depression. That's where the focus has to be.
And is he doing the job that needs to be done?
As I say, Senator Obama is working with Secretary Paulson, Chairman Bernanke's leaders of Congress to try to make sure this doesn't morph into something that tanks the retirement savings of every American person.
Austin Goolsbee, Senior Economics Advisor to Senator Obama. Good to see you. Thanks
for
coming on.
Good to see you.